In this video, we will be comparing the Hyundai Alcazar 2021 versus the Tata Safari 2021 with the MG Hector 2021. Hey guys, welcome to another video. I'm Aaron Moses. You're watching Cars United India, and let's start with the video. We have also provided timestamps in the timeline and in the description. You can click and go to your referred topic. But my suggestion is watch the video till the end to make the best buy. So let's start with the exterior, or rather let's start with the engines of each of these cars. So let's start with the petrol engine. So the Hyundai Alcazar comes with a 2-liter petrol engine that puts out about 117 kilowatts of power and with 191 newton meters of torque, with a mileage of 14 kilometers per liter. While the MG Hector comes with a 1.5-liter turbocharged engine that puts out about 143 PS of power with 250 newton meters of torque, with a mileage of 11 kilometers per liter. Sadly, the Tata Safari does not offer any petrol engines; it offers diesel engine. So let's check out diesel engine. The Hyundai Alcazar comes with a 1.5-liter CRDI diesel engine that puts out about 113 brake horsepower with 250 Nm of torque. The Tata Safari comes with a 2-liter turbocharged engine that puts out about 167 bhp of brake horsepower at 350 Nm of torque, while the MG Hector comes with a 2-liter turbocharged engine that puts out about 167 brake horsepower at 350 Nm of torque. The Tata Safari and the MG Hector comes with the same power to ratio, but the Hyundai Alcazar comes with slightly less power, I could say. Now let's check the dimensions of each of these cars. I'm not going to go in detail for the dimensions, or the video become too lengthy. I'll just tell you a brief. The MG Hector is the longest of all. The Tata Safari is the widest of all these three cars. The Tata Safari is also the tallest of the car and the longest wheelbase, while the Hyundai Alcazar comes with the longest wheelbase. Now let's check the interior of these cars, or the exterior. First, let's start with the exterior. Now let's start with the front look for each of these cars. This is the front look of the Hyundai Alcazar. It looks a bit like Creta, but they have done some minor or some major changes that puts it out a bit better than Creta. Let's check. This is the MG Hector front end, and this is the Tata Safari front end. All of these three, I would say the Hyundai Alcazar has bold stance in the front. Now let's check the headlamps of each of these cars. This is the headlamps of the Hyundai Alcazar. This is a tri-projector setup headlamps, two for the low beam and one for the high beam. And this is the Tata Safari headlamp. It gets projector cum reflector setup headlamps. The projector setup is LED headlamps for low beam, and the reflector setup is a halogen headlamps for the high beam. This is the MG Hector headlamps. It gets a projector setup for high beam and low beam, which are LEDs. Now let's check the DRLs for each of these cars. The Hyundai Alcazar comes with a DRL that looks a bit like Creta's DRL. This is the Tata Safari DRL that also acts as an indicator. And these are the DRLs for the MG Hector. There's a lot of attention to detail is given in the MG Hector, like the DRLs of the MG Hector. And let's check the front grille of the car. This is the front grille of the Hyundai Alcazar. It has chrome strips or chrome bars in the grill. And then this is the Tata Safari grill. It's very small grill that the Tata Safari gets. This is the MG Hector. It gets a big grill, a white brick. Now let's check the fog lamps of each of these cars. This is the fog lamp of the Hyundai Alcazar. It gets a reflector set of halogen fog lamps. The Tata Safari gets a reflector set of halogen fog lamps. The MG Hector also gets a reflector set of halogen fog lamps. Now let's check the side view of the car. The Hyundai Alcazar doesn't only look like a stretched Creta, but also has its own stance with a lot of cuts and creases on the sides. This is a side view of the Tata Safari. It just looks simple, but it does have its own styling. And this is the MG Hector Plus. It just looks like an MG Hector. They've just added extra seats, I guess. It just looks same. Now let's check the wheel size and rims of each of these cars. The Hyundai Alcazar comes with the 18-inch alloy wheels. The Tata Safari comes with a 17-inch alloy wheels. The MG Hector also comes with a 17-inch alloy wheels. Now let's check the rear view of each of these cars. This is the rear view of the Tata Safari. This is the rear view of MG Hector. Between the Tata Safari, it is quite simple, while the MG Hector looks like a truck because it has a lot of masculine cuts and creases, a lot of heaviness in the rear of the car. And this is the Hyundai Alcazar. It's quite simple, quite neatly designed rear. Now let's check the closer look of each of these cars, and now let's jump into the tail lamps for each of these cars. So these are the tail lamps for the Hyundai Altezza. It comes with a dotted tail lamp that is well lit during the night time and is quite impressive. These are Tata Safari tail lamps. It's not very complicated. I didn't like the tail lamps. Maybe it's depending on different choices, but it's just simple with some lines of DRL red lines and all of that. And these are the tail lamps of the MG Hector. It's white, complex headlamps, I would say. There's a dynamic swipe indicator. The headlamps are quite designed and it feels a lot modern. Now let's check the boot space of each of these cars. The Hyundai Altezza comes with a boot space of 180 liters and the Tata Safari comes with a boot space of 73 liters and the MG Hector comes with a boot space of 173 liters. Now let's hop into the interior of these cars. This is the interior of the Hyundai Altezza. It comes with a dark chocolate brown interior with black. It's a dual tone interior. This is the interior of the Tata Safari. You get a white theme and a black theme, like white and black theme. And this is the MG Hector interior. It gets a dark brown and a black interior, same as dual tone interior. Now let's check the instrument clusters of each of these cars. The Hyundai Altezza comes with a fully digital 10 inch instrument cluster. That's just out of this world. It's just modern. None of this segment offers this kind of features in their instrument cluster. This is the instrument cluster of the Tata Safari. It gets a partly digital, partly analog instrument cluster. This is the instrument cluster of the MG Hector. It's an analog instrument cluster with a big MID display in the center. Now let's take infotainment system of each of these cars. This is the Hyundai Altezza infotainment system. It comes with a 10.25 inch full touchscreen infotainment system. This has no competition. The Hyundai offers a lot of features such as the Hyundai Maps, Hyundai Blue Link, different types, and this car is fitted with a Bose 8 Sounds premium speakers. And this is the infotainment system of the Tata Safari. It gets an 8 inch touchscreen infotainment system with it gets Harman Kardon sound system. Now this is the MG Hector. It gets a huge infotainment system, but I guess it was not required. They have also attached the AC system right into the infotainment system, which some people might like, some people might not like. While you want to control the AC, your eyes have to be off the road, which is something that we have to consider, but it is big as of Tesla and rest of these cars. Now let's take the sunroof. All of these cars gets a panoramic sunroof. This is the sunroof of the Hyundai Altezza. The Tata Safari also gets a panoramic sunroof, and the MG Hector also gets a panoramic sunroof. Now let's take the second row of each of these cars. The Hyundai Altezza is offered in 6 and 7 seater, same as the MG Hector. And now the Tata Safari comes. This is the second row of the Tata Safari. This is the second row of the MG Hector. Now let's check the third row for each of these cars. This is the third row for the Hyundai Altezza. You get a USB and it's quite spacious. A person of height of 5'8", 5'6", can sit behind. While the Tata Safari, there's no place at all, only children can sit behind. Same goes for the MG Hector, only children can sit behind. So guys, this was the video or the comparison between the Hyundai Altezza versus the Tata Safari and the MG Hector. Now if you ask me which of these three cars are the best, I would say the Hyundai Altezza is the best out of these three. It is costly, it is less powered, but it does make up with the features that it offers interior, with the premiumness that it offers in the interior. But if you are someone who wants some other option, I would suggest you go for the MG Hector. It's also a lot premium, features is added in this car. And then if you're a diehard fan of Tata, then Tata Safari should be your option. Thank you for watching. Subscribe to Cars United India for more information on cars, bikes and comparison. Thank you.